Hollywood Chris Dobey.
I'm on the edge, I know the last. I work real hard to collect my cash. Tick, 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 take the time. When I'm going for mine. Open your ears and you will hear it. I tell you this, cause there's no limit.
No, 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 no.
Und jetzt kommt ein 49-jähriger Schotte. Er stand heuer bereits im Semifinale beim Masters, im Vorjahr im Finale beim World Grand Prix und in der Champions League of Darts. Er ist aktuell der Viertplatzierte im PDC-Ranking. Heißen wir herzlich willkommen in Graz Bremstetten, Snakebite, Peter Wright! Begrüßen wir auch den Caller dieser Partie mit einem Applaus, meine Damen und Herren, Kirk Bevins.
Third match of the evening session, day two of the Austrian Darts Open. Peter Snakebite Wright back on the European Tour stage once again up against Chris Dobey. It's been so far a slightly different story to the afternoon session, an afternoon session that witnessed the demise of six seeded players, but so far so good for the top dogs on stage this evening. Gerwin Price, the number two seed, beating John Henderson and Rob Cross. I think still wondering exactly how he still survived that ordeal against Jeffrey Desvarne, still scratching his head as to how he came through that. And maybe Chris Dobey is still wondering exactly how he came through his opening match last night at the expense of Andrew Gilding. Dobey had to survive nine match darts against Gilding to book his place in the second round and this meeting with Peter Snakebite Wright. It's the fifth meeting, I should say, between these two. They have met on the European Tour stage once before. That was in Gibraltar last year. Peter Wright winning that one 6-1. And Wright has overwhelmingly a pretty good record against Chris Dobey over the two or three years that they have met. Paul Nicholson alongside me, Rob Malarkey, for this one. And
ladies and gentlemen, first leg is Peter to throw first. Game on.
I suppose, Paul, the first question is, will Chris Dobey be perhaps treating last night as the big scare and using that as the platform on which to build? Or will Peter Wright still be wary of the disappointments he's suffered on the European Tour so far this season? 60.
I think Peter approaches every game with the same mentality, with swollen confidence. And that's just the way he is when he transforms into the Snakebite character that he's created for himself. I think Peter's almost oblivious to other people's plights and other people's results. He used to be a student of the game, but I think he's become someone who has immersed himself in his own stuff. But Chris Dobey will, I think, play with a bit more freedom now, because he fully expected to be beaten 6-3 yesterday. He wasn't.
58.
And he was disappointed not to have, you know, been more, you know, part of that game early on. But Andrew Gilden was brilliant. I spoke to Chris earlier and he said it was the first time since 32. I've been using the darker coloured stems and the darker flights that I've felt comfortable with them. And he says that's a big thing. So it's all going steam ahead for Dobey, who was looking to get himself out of the bubble spots for the match play and potentially get himself in the tournament.
Just to qualify what I said about Peter Wright and the disappointments on the European tour so far this year, he did kick off the campaign with a semi-final appearance in Leverkusen, lost to Rob Cross in that semi-final, lost to Adrian Lewis in the quarters in Hildesheim, but since then, in the last two tournaments on the European tour, he's only won one match. That was at the German Darts Open last weekend. But the trouble is with Peter Wright, he has set himself very high standards on the European Tour with that phenomenal run of form he had at the start of 2017. Made a couple of finals last year as well. But this year, it's in the main not really happened for him.
Chris needs treble 18. Gets it. Tops for an early break.
74.
Just went to the left side because the flight might have 70. Been guarding the middle piece. Peter spent a bit of time at the table there. What's he expecting to hear? Game shot in the first leg to Dobey. But it wasn't said. And Peter's got tops. And he misses by roughly the same margin. Perfect guide.
These are 40. Opportunities that may well come back to haunt Chris Dobey. If he returns, it will be for double 10, but I suspect Peter Wright might not give him the opportunity. Or maybe he will.
20.
Well.
Well, one thing I'm really surprised by, Rob, is that when he was on 70, he went for treble 10. I can't for the life of me remember what the last time he went for treble 10. He always goes for treble 18 for double 8. Now, that's a tricky one. It's all the way over into Andrew Gilding country.
Yeah, he shot the first leg.
And how ironic Chris, that he gets the shot.
Second leg is Chris to throw first. Game on.
Now, Peter Wright has not changed his darts in a couple of weeks now, and he started to show some form. During the week, he had some astronomical averages.
125. And
he almost hit the wall when he played Harry Ward in the second players' championship during the week. But it was really encouraging to see Peter having those monstrous statistics that we're used to seeing from him, you know, 18 months ago to 3 years ago. I think he believes in what he's throwing with right now, and it's just a question of
94.
How long is he going to be using them? How much faith does he have in this setup? Because there's no flinching when it comes to how much faith he has in himself.
Yeah, he produced an outstanding performance in Barnsley on Wednesday. 114.2, the average, and that 6-0 whitewash of Gary Anderson in the last 32. But then, as you say, losing 6-5 to Harry Ward in the very next round, it was a bizarre 58. Couple of hours or so. He did also make it to the quarterfinals on the Tuesday as well.
This is better.
140.
But he did suffer a couple of first round defeats on the Pro Tour last month as well. And in the Premier League, it's just not happened for him over the past few weeks. 3 points from his last nine matches. He's not won any of those nine matches. 3 draws and 6 defeats. And he's had some pretty heavy ones as well.
Absolutely right. He's going to go double-double here, but I don't see the value in that.
24.
I really don't.
Richard Wilde, 164.
When your opponent is on a huge finish like this, this is a 3% shot. He doesn't like that first dart.
Not in the slightest, no. But yeah, I mean, I see your point. It's. I think if the margins have been tighter, then that's the time to go for it.
Only going to get one shot at a double. He's not even going to get any. From 96, he's thrown six darts. And he's left himself double 15.
And Dobey could well steal this one.
This is a double-double shot.
Tops. Not to be.
60.
But that was the right time to do it.
That's the right time to do it. When the margins
are tight. The right time.
Yeah. And now Peter Wright looking at double 15. Now, I was just going to say, I've seen him take out double 15 a fair few times on the European Tour of late, and he does like the double 15. He's not afraid of it, shall we say, anyway.
No. It's not a bad double, it's just not ideal because it's an odd number. And maybe he's been going to the Michael Smith school of leaving doubles, because he loves double 15. Very frustrating start to this match. It's been quite symptomatic of what we've seen in the first day and a half. It's been a bit odd.
Yeah, Dobey started off with a 21 dart breaker throw, and Peter Rice has levelled things up with a 16 dart break. It's been a scruffy start. But as he said, it was bizarre that he was on 96 and then needed six darts to get down to 30.
Well, first game of the night, Gerwin Price was playing against John Henderson and played very well against the crowd that didn't greet him very well at all. He's since taken to social media and talked about his, well, no love for Austria. But something did happen in that match. He averaged exactly the same as John Henderson. It was 91.67. And our statistician friends have been in touch and said that that is the only the second time that identical averages have occurred. And the last time it happened was in the Premier League between Andy Hamilton and Raven van Barneveld, when they both had 95.71 in the 2012 edition of the Premier League. So it's quite incredible.
100.
That's some time ago as well. So, yeah.
Well, the thing about that is as well, that's a lot of people are probably going to get in touch and say, well, there have been identical averages in the past. There have been four others that have been corrected two decimal places, but this one was a dead heat.
Wow.
Exactly the same amount of darts, exactly the same amount of points scored in the match. It was 133 darts each, 4,064 points each. Absolutely stunning.
100. Pity require 76.
Right. No double-double here, Peter. He's going to stay up top for one shot at double 18. And he gets it. First hold to throw in the match. It seems to me like Peter Wright is the slightly sharper of the two right now. But like we saw yesterday with Chris and Andrew Gilding, maybe he's just toying with him and maybe going to take him all the way to 11 legs and save his best stuff for the end.
Yeah, Dobey's certainly better than this. I mean, from what we've seen of him so far this weekend, he was very fortunate to come through yesterday, and I don't think he's really done himself any justice so far.
180.
And all the while, Peter Wright just seems to be making gradual improvements, almost leg on leg and visit on visit to some extent as well. Never gone beyond the semi-finals of this tournament, Peter Wright, in all the years he's played it. He did play in the very first edition in 2012. But he was a semi-finalist here, or in this tournament, in 2014.
96.
When it was held elsewhere. He lost to Jamie Cavan, 6-5 in that semi-final. Disappointing visit last year, though. He was beaten in the second round by James Wade. Wade was an unseeded player. Had to go through qualifying. And Wade did for him 6-4.
Yeah, and Wade was done by Gezi Price.
Salzburg, 2014, this tournament.
Fine
the
place,
one and only.
Salzburg. Fine yeah. place.
The one and only visit to Salzburg for the Austrian Darts Open. It's travelled around a little bit, this tournament. A couple of years in Wiener Neustadt, and Vienna hosted it for 2 years running as well, 16 and 17.
Peter Wright's going for 57 here on the 85. Great dart, that. Double 14 and two pokes at it. Doesn't even need to move on the hockey. And that's why. That's a really nice kill from Wrighty. And he's starting to charge a little bit. He's had a scratchy start, but he's sharpened up. And Chris has a little bit of exasperation there. Just a little bit of frustration creeping in, potentially. But there's one thing we know about Chris Dobey, is that he's able to command his emotions. And his composure is something to behold sometimes. All we've got to do is cast our minds back to that epic world championship run he had games with Vincent van der Voort and Anderson that I would watch every day for the rest of my life. They were that good.
Yeah, he was so close against Gary Anderson. It's something that again may well come back to haunt him. I suspect he will have better opportunities to go deeper into the world championship,
123,
But you just worry with Chris sometimes. I mean, we talked about it yesterday, this inability so far in his career to make it to Blackpool. It seems to be something he's desperate to tick off on his bucket list. And I think maybe he's just applying a bit too much pressure on himself, and maybe that is having an impact on his game. It's a possibility. I'm not saying that's, you know, a certainty by any stretch of the imagination.
Yeah, it is a possibility, because he has found himself 49. On the bubble so many times, it's become almost second nature. But because he's in the four consecutive European Tour events, and we're in three of four now, he's given himself the best opportunity to get himself there. But I said this yesterday, a lot of these players, they focus on doing well in tournaments to get into other big ones. They should focus on trying to win this one. Win a title. Has been in finals, Chris, but he hasn't been in a final of the Euro Tour yet. And I'm sure that is in his locker.
And again, we made that point yesterday about Chris Dobey, in that he's been picking up money here and there, but what he could really do with is just a morale-boosting, confidence-boosting, career-surging title. I mean, he's gone close on the Pro Tour before.
Yeah, he's on the fifth leg, Peter Wright.
Great stuff from Peter Wright. His doubling is starting to get polished up. And look at the desire on the face of Snakebite. He knows that he's at a point in his season where he needs to start kicking on. Now, cast your mind back 12 months to this tournament, where Gerwyn Price was eliminated from the Premier League, and everybody said, "Oh, it's ruined him. His game's in pieces." Came here, made the final.
80.
It's a myth. Gerwyn Price kicked on from this tournament, then he went on to play well in other tournaments, and then he got the Grand Slam. Now, Peter Wright's starting to do that very thing. He's focusing from here.
I mean, I thought there were times last year where Gerwyn Price really just looked like he wanted the whole Premier League thing to come to an end, and I think it did. Well, it was a huge weight off his shoulders, and he did look like a different man when he came to Austria.
85.
Peter Wright, as we know, has been eliminated from the Premier League. He can't make it into the playoffs. Of course, he still has his fixtures to fulfil, but he can't go any further. And maybe the shackles are off to an extent with Peter Wright as well. And it's just another chapter of the season he can put behind him, and he can move on now.
Well, the good thing is that where he lives, travelling to Sheffield and Leeds, not that far.
140.
So the travelling element is about to get a little bit easier for Peter. Now Chris needs double eight for the best leg of the match for him. And yeah, that is much better. 11 darter.
7 leg is Peter to throw first.
Yeah, it's an 11 dart hold. There was that 12 dart break for Peter Wright in leg four, but that's more like it from Chris Dobey. That's exactly what we were talking about. We were saying he's capable of better than what he's produced so far this weekend.
Nice.
And that was clearly the best illustration of it. Nice, neat and tidy 76 checkout after the approach play of a 140, a 180 and a 105. And he's in the red stuff once again here.
Oh, it takes a special player to do that, you know. You've got two in the bottom of the 60 and you've got to find a quarter of a bed or somehow find it underneath with some power. That is some real, real skill that Chris Dobey has.
100.
You can look at the deliberate rhythm of Chris Dobey and just guarantees a straight arm and throws right down the line of the dart. Technically,
81.
It's probably one of the top three actions in the world.
That's high praise indeed.
Well, there's no deviation, there's no kinking of the elbow. All of the lines are right, the balance 89. Is good. Kids out there, if you're looking to mimic an action, I'd strongly suggest this one.
Yeah, and Phil Taylor was highly complimentary about Chris Dobey a couple of years ago after Taylor beat Dobey in his first match in what was Taylor's final world championship. I mean, it's something that's been said by many others as well, but that's the ultimate accolade, I suppose, from the 16-time world champion, the outgoing world champion, or former world champion as he was at the time. Now, if Dobey can just post something healthy here, he may well be able to start thinking about a break of throw, but he's losing his way at just the worst possible time.
50.
He's done the right thing there. He's had two poor darts and he thought, well, what can I leave that's doable? 130 is the right leave, but he may not even get a look at it.
17 or would have left the ball. It's a grimace from Peter Wright because he knows Dobey has an outside chance here. He's definitely got a bit of a sniff. Needs the treble and he can't find it.
Such a well-thrown dart. It just didn't collide with that first marker enough.
And shame about the last dart as well. Okay, he's on a two-dart combination for a finish there. But Peter Wright's looking at 64. Again, the first dart. No damage done because he's looking at tops anyway. And that's really well tied it up. Didn't let that first dart derail him too much. Just refocused, moved around the board, and picked off what he needed. 5-2.
I'm never derogatory towards people who I really respect, but even Peter would say that those first two darts were poor. He misses the single 16 when going for the treble, and even the single shot at 17, it was almost too high. But the double top absolutely negated those two bad darts. That was a beautiful shot.
And it's the sign of a good player. The fact there was no sort of grimacing or exasperation. He just maintained his focus and just had a look and just picked up the pieces and moved on.
Well, more often than not, anywhere with a shot like 64, you're going to get one dart. And the thing is, he gave himself one dart.
57.
Yeah, it's a quite a versatile target, isn't it, 64, if you do slip up, given what's either side of the bed.
57.
You know, if you go for that 16 area, if you miss upstairs, you're going into the 8s. That's obviously not a massive hindrance anyway, especially if you hit the treble.
Well, there's a lot of people out there who go for treble 8 on 64 these days. And if you happen to slip into the 48, the treble 16, then you've got a shot that's very close by.
60.
Dobey, a semi-finalist on the Pro Tour this year. He reached his third final in a ranking event in October of last year on the Players' Championship circuit. Lost to Christoph Rutajski in that one. So he's had good runs, but he's not been able to string a lot of good runs together.
He always seems to run into the wrong guy in the
he
final.
He does. I mean, you can only beat or play what's put in front of you. That's the thing. But Dobey will look at those, and he may well feel he's had his unfair share of tough draws to navigate his way through.
Double 8. Great shot. And just like the other leg from Peter Wright, where he had a poor first dart, Chris Dobey looked at the score and calculated what he needed and whether going for the treble 17 was the right shot. It was in that spot, and he killed it. Kept himself alive. Yeah, Dobey in one of his finals averaged 110 and it wasn't enough against MVG. And then he found himself against Rutajski when Rutajski could do no wrong.
Yeah, that was 109.63 that Rutajski averaged that day. Oh, no, sorry, it was 109.63 when he played Van Gerwen. Sorry, you're right. But yeah, Rutajski posted a very healthy average himself in that final towards the end of last year.
I think in order to compete these days on the Players' Championship stuff anyway, you tend to find the averages are a lot higher because there's a bit less pressure there. There's no crowd. The library atmosphere, and people tend to get a bit more focused. But you've got to have a personal best sort of area between 108 and 115. And Peter Wright has shown this week that he has the 115 game in him. 100. And Dobey has shown in the last 12 months that he has the 110 level as well.
Well, Peter Wright on his throw has not been totally convincing. He was broken in the very first leg that he threw first. There was an 18 dart hold, a 15 dart hold, and an 18 dart hold for 5-2. So that tells you that Dobey potentially has openings here, and he's got an opening now looking at 1-2-1 on the right throw. Treble 17 had to go for the bullseye, but still 57. There's every chance here that Dobey could find a way through, looking at 64 if he gets the opportunity.
419s should be the shot. Peter favours double 16 usually, and that's a guide for a 57. That one's come up way short. He will be inside. He'll be livid with that dart. It had no chance of hitting the 57. Now, Dobey, can he do that act of escapology once more?
Looks as though he may well have to. And he has. What a response from Chris Dobey. Interesting as well that Peter Wright went down to the treble 10 again.
Tell you what,
to leave himself the 40, but it doesn't matter anyway because Dobie's back on terms, trailing 5-4, but with the throw here.
If you were to put Chris Dobey on a gurney right now, and I'm not talking about Darryl, and if you went over him with the paddles to revive him, he'd say, I don't need no paddles. I just come back from the dead.
Well, there is every chance that Chris Dobey could pull off another escape act here. Maybe not on a par with the magnitude of the one he had last night and the good fortune that went his way last night as well, in the sense that he was the beneficiary of 9 missed match darts by Andrew Gilding, but still 5-3 down, needing to win 3 on the spin. He's got the break.
What was really funny earlier is that when he was getting changed out of his dart shirt and putting his t-shirt back on, when he was practicing earlier, I walked up to him and said, all right, Lazarus. He had no idea what I was talking about.
Another one of Sid Waddell's great lines.
Absolutely.
As well.
One of the best. It's a good first start for Peter. And now that's got to be filled up. Too easy.
Well, I was expecting it to go in between the two, but he tucked it into the top left-hand corner anyway for good measure, and he's down to a finish first on the Dobey throw, and this one may well turn the other way because Peter Wright, with Dobey on 160, Peter Wright is looking at 157. But 157 is not going to go, but 160 may well have to go for Chris Dobey.
65. Decent last start. He's on 92. Precarious this leg. There could be misses. And that miss from Dobey on the 60.
57.
And consequently on the next 92. Two trebles means that Peter may go the 60 here instead of going for the bull. I think he's looking up top. Yeah, now he's going double double. That was the right time to do it.
56.
But he wasn't able to execute the double 18 at any point when he did double-double. 51 needed. Now he needs misses, does Dobey. Is he going to get more mismatched darts?
I suspect he won't. Peter Wright has 3 darts at double 18. He's squandered the first. One or two fans are waiting to celebrate. He's hit a single 4, so he's now looking at double 14.
He's going the double 4. Wow, he's had 3 missed match darts against him. Again. Double 16. Edge of your seat stuff. And he's in again. Oh, my word. How is this happening?
Chris Dobey must have some form of sign over the rest of the field this weekend. No matter what you do, things are going to go his way. Things are falling into place, and Peter Wright has kicked off with a 60 here. This is astonishing.
I'll tell you what, if Chris Dobey was a boxer, he's got a chin like Thanos. You just can't knock him out. This has been a very edgy game, and this last leg is going to tell us one heck of a story. Now, funnily enough, Andrew Gilding lives in Suffolk. So does Peter Wright. But Peter Wright is finding that 60 in this last leg.
140.
He's got the advantage of throw, and he's magnified it there with that 140.
3 missed match darts for Peter Wright in that 10th leg.
140.
Strayed into the double 4, left himself double 14, couldn't find it. And this deciding leg is in the balance. Absolutely astonishing that Chris Dobey finds himself in this position once again.
If he gets 2 trebles here, he might be in the driving seat. Gets the 1.
Leave double 16 for Peter Wright for a place in the third round. and Peter Wright conjures up a finish of 104 to break the hearts of Chris Dobey, who in the end perhaps ran out of steam and certainly ran out of luck. He was 5-3 down, but still he somehow managed to claw his way back into a position where he was challenging in the decider. But it's the end of the road for Chris Dobey.
Wieder ein äußerst spannendes Spiel war das hier bei den Austrian Darts Open in Graz. Wir bedanken uns für dieses Match und verabschieden ihn mit einem kräftigen Applaus aus Graz. Chris Dobey! Und er ist eine Runde weiter und wir sehen ihn morgen wieder, meine Damen und Herren, Peter Wright! Thank you, Chris Dobey. Peter, that was a quite exciting game. You don't look really satisfied.
No, I'm not satisfied at all, but I felt like I let these guys down, and because they were supporting me, behind me, and I felt like I did play rubbish. But Chris Dobey's an amazing player. Both of us, we didn't perform like we can, so I'd just like to say sorry. But thank you for supporting both of us.
Also, sagt, mit seinem Spiel war gar nicht so zufrieden, aber auf jeden Fall für die Fähre und für die super Unterstützung in Graz. Chris Dobey sagt, er ist natürlich ein großartiger Spieler, es war nicht leicht für ihn. What about your plans for tonight? Going to bed early or having a little party maybe?
No, I think I'll go to bed about 6 o'clock in the morning.
Maybe it's a long day for you tomorrow.
It worked with Chizzy last week, so no, not really. Back to bed early night. I need to sleep, boy. Look at these eyes, you know.
Yeah, you look good. Okay, also wird bald zu Bett gehen, damit er morgen fit ist. Wir sehen ihn wieder. Looking forward to see you again tomorrow. Peter Wright!